It's Micah, the ADHD Stitcher, here for another episode, episode number 11 of my Floss Tube. And today is December 6th. It is a Monday, 2021. And if the camera shakes, I'm sorry. Cat's climbing on the table. Here we go. Let's just start it off right. As you can see, I'm in a new location. I wanted to bring you some of my Christmas joy. I don't have everything up yet, but thought I'd show you some of what I have up. And at some point when I get everything up, I will do a tour for you, kind of show you all of my Christmas decorations, because I do love to decorate for Christmas. It's something that my mom always did, a lot of decorating, and I definitely took that on and would like to take on even more than I already do. But, you know, you run out of time at some point. And by the time you get it all up, it's time to take it down again once you get to a certain point. And I guess while we're looking at these are stockings made by my mother-in-law. She makes stockings for everyone in the family. This was Justin's from when he was a child. Isn't it cute with that Snoopy? You just showed that to Chris Cross Stitch. He would like that Snoopy. And then, sorry, I'm knocking stuff down. And then, of course, she made ones for the kids after they were born. And then this is the one she made me when we got married. And she makes those from kits. I guess, I don't know. I guess she gets them from somewhere like Hobby Lobby or online. I'm really not sure, to be honest. Sorry if I just shook the camera. So there's that. And of course, our lovely, I love these little twinkle lights, the little bitty fairy lights. I love them. I want to transition to having those everywhere because you don't have to change bulbs. Very, very nice. And I'm not sure if you can hear it or not. When my daughter takes a shower, she listens to her tablet really high. And I can hear it pretty clearly. If you can hear that, I'm sorry. I apologize. I was trying to make this video earlier and my phone did not have enough battery to make it through. So I had to wait till I got home. Let's see. Last week I talked about filming some Stitch With Me's. I actually did film one, but the sound quality was horrible because the phone holder thing that I have that it could use to look straight down at my stitching was covering up part of the mic. So it did not sound good at all. So I'm going to do some experimentation and try to find a different way to do that. Maybe use the mic from this setup or something like that so that you can hear better, and maybe I can do some of those. Trying to think of what's gone on since last week. My daughter's been getting ready for her voice show, which is this weekend. So we had dress rehearsal last weekend. My son's been playing basketball. I guess just standard, your kids are in elementary and middle school. It's close to Christmas stuff. So, I'm sorry, my cat's got, I don't know what she has. Hold, please, before she chokes on something she shouldn't have.
What do you got?
Yeah, so I'm glad I got that. If you don't like spiders, look away. This is what she had. Now, when my son bought these with, like, birthday money or something, I told him he could not scare me with them, which they don't because I know what they look like, and we don't have spiders that look like that in our house. But the cat was trying to eat it. It would not be good. I have to talk to him about leaving those out. Now what is she eating? My goodness. Sorry, hold again. Well, I'm not sure what that was, but she got it eaten before I could catch her. Anyway. Oh my goodness, she's wild. And it's the one that's usually not so wild that's wild. It's Claudia that's wild today. Usually it's Cleo. Alright, so. Back to focus. Yeah, life's just been regular this past week, I guess. That's what I was trying to say. I did do something to my back. I don't know what. I'm hoping it's going to calm down because I have to get the house the rest of the way decorated and cleaned this week. We have Justin's family coming over this weekend for his immediate family's Christmas. Oh, my word. She's crazy. Like, her tail is all poofed out and she's hopping around like a weirdo. Anyway, sorry again. Gonna be one of those. All right. One thing that I meant to talk about before actually, and I forgot last week, was that Reagan and I have recently started doing some diamond painting. We've just started. I'm sorry, y'all. We haven't ever done it before. We're new at it. The piece I got is like a hummingbird with a watercolor background, which is just the hummingbird on mine that's going to actually be diamond painted. And hers is a big poster of the solar system, and hers is full coverage. So I told her I would help her with all the background if she wanted. But if that's something that y'all would be interested in seeing, let me know. We can show y'all our diamond painting progress. It's been fun. You know, it's similar to cross stitch in that it's kind of like pixel art, you know, each little squares or little whatever shapes. Oh my goodness. I'm sorry. But, you know, it's similar to cross stitch in that way. But obviously it's just sticking the thing on there, not actually stitching. But so yeah, that's been really fun. When I worked on that was really fun. I enjoyed that a lot. And then I wanted to give a shout out to a fellow floss tuber. It's Kathleen at Stituation Normal. I've been watching her for the past several months after I heard Elizabeth Ann Can Stitch talking about her, which I love Elizabeth Ann also. If you're not watching her, she's a great one to watch. They're both really fun. But Kathleen is one that I don't think I had mentioned on my channel yet that I do watch regularly. And so I was like, well, I need to give Kathleen a shout out. I do really enjoy watching her and listening to her Canadian accent, which I'm calling it a Canadian accent. It's probably even more regionally specific than that. But, you know, I don't know my Canadian accents. She does a lot of fun projects, and she has also recently been talking about her ADHD journey a little bit. And so, obviously, I feel you on that, Kathleen. I get that. And so, if you haven't checked her out, you should definitely check her out. She's a lot of fun to watch. So, something else that I wanted to talk about this week were my previous finishes that are Christmas related. I don't have a lot of decoration wise. I just haven't decorated with a lot of cross stitch in the past because I haven't been connected enough to the community to have seen patterns that I really liked and would want to have stitched and up around the house. I have one thing that I hang up and then the rest are ornaments. But as you know, I'm rectifying that this year with all the Christmas starts. But this is, you've heard me talk about Stitch People before. This is my Christmas Stitch People portrait. Stitch People has, there's the main Stitch People book, and then there's also a lot of different add-on books. And this is the Christmas book that has lots of different Christmas accessories and outfits and all that kind of good stuff. And too, this year they just came out with a Christmas background book. Really, really nice big backgrounds if you like a fuller picture. They also have really great Nutcracker set, a series that has the Nutcracker. They have also a... Oh, why am I forgetting the word? Christmas Carol. The Christmas Carol. You know, Scrooge and all that. They have a set for that as well. So, this was the mix and match, Christmas mix and match patterns I made my kids look like Buddy the Elf because we always watch Elf every year on Christmas Eve. And so, yeah, that's what I did in 2017. Originally, I was going to do one every year, but in 2018, I just didn't have time. And so then after that, it was like, well, I don't want to do, have 1 year missing. So that's how I am. I'm all or nothing a lot of times. It's an ADHD thing, this whole all or nothing thing. But I probably will do another one at some point because there are so many cute different things. I would love to do different ones that are all different setups and everything. So there's that one. That's my only bigger piece. Sorry, I'm trying to set it down somewhere. I won't get it messed up. I've got stuff everywhere from decorating. All right, then drink. I have some more that actually are based on some of the different patterns from the Christmas book, the Stitch People Christmas book, where I cross-stitched some different little motifs from some of the things and put them on ornaments. These are wooden ornaments I got at Hobby Lobby a few years ago. I thought originally maybe I could somehow wrap the fabric around here, but there's just not enough space. Now, if I could go back, I would just like back it with felt or something and just attach. You could even put like a little batting there to make it poofy a little bit, but I just glued the wood piece in and then glued that on there. So we had that wreath. This may have been one of my first experiences with the metallic DMC that is not fun to work with, but it works. Here is a little Rudolph. And again, these are all motifs from that Stitch People Mix and Match Christmas book. This one is one of the motifs, but I doubled the size of it. So it's a nutcracker. And I did shiny green on him too. Ooh, look at that. I did French knots with that metallic DMC. Go me. That's not easy. This one, ooh, it's starting to slip out. I might have to re-glue this one this year. Candy canes. A little snowflake. And then a little Christmas tree. So those are all some I did with Stitch People motifs from the Christmas Mix and Match book or whatever it is. Words. This one I just made up. My pretty tree is, if you can't guess from the stuff behind me, is buffalo plaid, the red and black buffalo plaid. And I wanted to make something. So I did not know about waste canvas or soluble canvas or any of that stuff. It's covered with felt on the back now. But what I did was I literally took a piece of Aida and stuck it to, I pinned it flat onto a piece of the flannel that I had. And then I just stitched through that Aida. It was a trial and error process. Sometimes it didn't stick it in quite the right spot, but so yeah, that one I just was winging it. Oh, this one last year I made that one. Wow, the light is good grief. There we go, that's better. Yeah, 2020 dumpster fire. That one I just made up looking at a picture of a dumpster. That was just some pom-poms from, I don't know, maybe Walmart, and some scrap Christmas fabric on the back that I had. And then these are not cross stitch, but I did show you some of this kind of stuff on my first video that I like to do with Mod Podge. I like to decoupage mosaic style with magazine pieces cut out of magazines, and the only problem is this has a little buzz stuck to it. Sometimes in the attic, you know. Oh, great. Why did I do that? Now there's buzz floating in the air. Maybe it'll calm down. Sorry. So, yep, there's a snowflake that I made. And there's holly and berries. There's another one I did that I really, really liked that I think my mom had requested. Because I made these actually originally to sell. And didn't really sell them. And not many of them anyway. Probably because I charge what you should and nobody really wants to pay for it. But my mom has one that I made that's a wreath. So it's like green with some little red berries and a red bow. And then I made Tennessee Vols orange tea. I'm sorry if you're offended by my offensive Vols orange, but I'm not sorry. Sorry, not sorry. Go Vols. That's how you know I'm a true Vols fan. I'm still saying it. Still saying it after all the trauma we've been through. And then, of course, for my husband, St. Louis. He's a big St. Louis Cardinals fan. So, those are some, and of course, I have a lot of other types of ornaments that I've made, but those are the ones relating to cross-stitch and other kinds of things that you've seen from me before. So, I wanted to show those to you. And, yeah, that's all my previous finishes. So, the next thing to show you will be whips. The first one is an almost finish. I literally am lacking just a few stitches. So it's the second of my Merry Christmas from Liz Matthews 2020 freebie that I'm making for my sisters-in-law. You can see all I'm missing is part of that R, and I will be finished. I will have to gift these before you will see them. So I will, after I get them FFO'd, I'll take pictures and I'll show it to you so you can see what I did. And I'll try to take nice detailed pictures so you can see how it was done and everything. And if I have time, maybe I'll try to video it. We'll see. I don't know. This week's going to get interesting, so we'll see. So there's that one. Then my next whip is Christmas Goodies from the Frosted Pumpkin Stitchery. It's going to look like this. And then here's what it looked like last time. And this week, it's not much different. Can you see what I did? Curious. Can you figure it out? I did some of the light blue going around. That's what I worked on actually when I filmed the stitch with me that you won't get to see. So yeah, that's all I got done on that this week because I've been working hard on the one for my sister-in-law because she has to get it this weekend. So I need it done. Then the next whip that I have. Oh, and I'm so horrible at this. I keep forgetting. This is done on 14 count black Aida, and it is done with a DMC Coloris thread that is number. Sorry, I'm making noise. It is number 4520. So that's what that one is. And then my Christmas goodies in, oh yeah, and this is in my Dot Dot Goose design bag. I showed y'all last time. Santa and Mrs. Claus and the cookies. This is a 32 count. Even weave, I think Murano Car is what it's called, from Zweigart. I think the color is Ice, very, very, very light blue. Hardly any color at all to it, but it is a tiny little bit of blue. And the threads are all the called for DMCs, except for changing up the placement a little bit, like putting this light blue around here since the white one won't show on here very well. Then my next whip, please pardon me because I dropped it in the floor. Okay, so my next piece is my Justin, if you are watching this, go away piece. Go away. Get. All right, this is the Jim Shore button, or Mill Hill gift bearing Santa. I was trying to read backwards on the camera. Ornament. And now there is a Cleo on the table. Cleo, come here. Say hi to your best friends. Look. Look at the camera that you love so much. Look. 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 It's you. It's you. She's not impressed at all. Stay off the table. So, this is what I'm doing for Justin as a Christmas gift. Here is where it was last time. And I did not get very far at all. I think all I had before was part of the beard. And I have part of the beard and a little bit of his coat. So, not very much. I gotta kick it in gear so I can get that done. It definitely won't be done before they get the tree, before they decorate their tree, because that will have to be done before this weekend, and there is absolutely no way this is getting done. I've mentioned before that Justin and the kids have their own tree that they can do whatever they want to on. They call it the fun tree. And whenever the kids grow up and move out, he is going to make it a Santa tree with full of Santa ornaments. And so I wanted to make him a Santa that he could have on the tree now and that would stay on the tree in the future. But that's definitely not getting done this week, so hopefully I can get it done by Christmas at this point. We'll see how that goes. And then, that's technically all of my whips. Well, sort of. I do have one new start, if you can call it that. I'm gonna call it that. So I told you last time that I was gonna do the Barbara Anna Christmas Sal, which this is just the first release. The second release is out, but I haven't printed it out yet. Yes, I'm calling it a start. You ready? There it is. A teeny tiny top of a snowman head. That's all I got. And basically that was just so that I could say, hey, look, I have another start and have something to show. So, I'm doing this on a 32 count Murano car by Zweigart, and I cannot remember the name of the color. It is, I don't remember. I will go check the package when I'm done, and when I edit, I'll put the name in here, the name of the colorway. And when I'm talking about this Murano cars from Zweigart, they are sold under the Artiste brand at Hobby Lobby. So that's a good way. You can get like some even weaves and stuff, and even some linens. The Cashel linen that I've been using is also from there. Obviously, they're not going to be as nice as what you could get elsewhere, but sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. And that one's living in this project bag that you haven't got to see in a minute. This is one from Stitch in Peace. that I got on Etsy a while back. I really like that bag. I need to get some more. I need more bags. So that is the end of my whips and new starts. That is all that I have going on right now. As far as haul goes, I don't have anything physical to show you. I have a couple of things I'm going to show you pictures of because they're PDFs that I got this week. The first one, it's all the fault, all totally and completely the fault of Just Keep Stitching. Stam. Let's call him Stam now. Instead of Pam and Steph or Steph and Pam, let's just call him Stam. That works for me. Hashtag Stam. Make it happen. I'm sure they'll love that. Oh, me. Well, and what's the other way if you're going to have Pam be first? Because I know they both like to be first. Piff? It doesn't work out as well as Stam. Sorry. Sorry, Pam. We're going to have to go with Stam. So Steph will be first. Anyway. Tangent. This was a pattern that they featured last week. Not the newest video, but last week's video. From Twin Peak Primitives. It is called Christmas Morning at Santa's Kitchen. I thought that it was so cute. I really, really liked it. I know I'm not going to have time to get to it this year. That's definitely not going to happen. But since it was 20% off, I figured why not go ahead and grab it. So I'll have it in my stash. And then the other one I will blame on Liz from Elizabeth Ankin Stitch. But that's okay, because it was a freebie, so it didn't cost me anything. And that is Berries in Bloom from Hands On Design. That was a freebie from last year, I do believe. If you get on their Facebook group, you can find it there. I thought, when I saw her working on it, I thought that it was just so pretty. I thought it was super, super cute. And I love it. And I thought that it was something that my mom might like. Mom, you don't hear this if you happen to be watching. I don't think you really watch these anymore. But if you do, now you don't know. It's magic. Pretend it works. But if I have time, I might try to make one of these for my mom for Christmas. I think Elizabeth Ankin Stitch put a video out today. A finishing tutorial. It was either today or yesterday. A finishing tutorial of how she made hers into an ornament. And it looks super, super cute. So I would really like to, I don't know that I'll make one for myself this year, but at some point I'll make it. And with me and all these Christmas things, I love Christmas. I will stitch it all year long. So whatever I don't get started and don't get worked on right now, it's okay. Because I'll just work on it all year. Because I love Christmas. let's see. Oh, and then also, for plans, I will work on all these things. The main thing I got to do is get that ornament done for Justin. And what? This happens to me every video. This light starts fading. It just does not like to last as long as I talk. What is the deal, man? So I want to get that done for him for Christmas. Then also would like to form sentences with words. I completely blanked on whatever it was I was going to say. I really don't know where I was going with that. I'm being Michael Scott. That's what I was doing. I was pulling a Michael Scott where you just start the sentence with no idea where it's going to go and hope it works out for the best. I'll find a clip. If I can't insert it, I will. If I can't figure it out, I'll put a link in the show notes or in the description box so you know what I'm talking about. Anyway, get it back together. Can't talk anymore. It broke. It's broken. Plans. We're talking about plans. Finish the ornament. That's what I was saying. I'm going to finish the ornament. And once that's done, and I have to FFO those things for my sisters-in-law. That has to be done before this weekend because I have to give it to them. Although I have been known to give gifts late. In fact, I still have a crochet whip that's been a whip for probably about 8 years. 7 years. It's for my niece who was born that long ago. With one of her baby presents that I never finished. Still haven't finished it. Still have pieces of it, but it's not done. Anyway. So I have to finish those. And then after that's done, I'll just work on whatever's calling me. Because like I said, if I don't finish it this year, it'll be okay. I really did want to get the Stitching with the Housewives Into All a Good Night done this year, but I have not been able to get it started on time. So that's not gonna get done. It'll be okay. But another thing in plans that I do want to talk about is Lindy Stitches Birds to the Bows. If you did not see last week's video, this is going to be my birthday start. My birthday is January 13th. And this is a piece that I've just really loved since the moment I laid eyes on it. And so I decided that's what I'm going to start for my birthday. And I know some of you are going to join in. I know I saw that Crystal is and Becky is and who else was it? There was at least a couple, one or two more names of people who said they were going to start it with us. And now I don't remember. I should have written them all down. We'll do that for next time. Should know better than to trust my brain to hold that. But so if you would like to join us, you will have time to get what you need. As you can see, I ordered the physical copy from Lindy Stitch's website. And I also ordered the fabric from her. It calls for a 32 count Silvery Moon Lugana. And like I said, I ordered that from her a couple weeks ago whenever I ordered this. So she had it in stock then. And all of the flosses that it calls for are DMC. So I'll raid my stash and then go buy what I need. But so that's easy enough. That's accessible enough for everyone. And that won't be too hard to get a hold of. And if you do join us, the hashtag for it, or if you'd just like to follow along, the hashtag for that will be Micah's B-Day Sal, S-A-L, Stitch Along. And I'll put that on there, hashtag Micah's B-Day Sal. That'll be the hashtag that we can all use so we can follow each other's progress. I realize now my light is like completely gone, but you know what? We're just going to roll with it because I need to finish this. And I need to leave in a few minutes to go to my son's ball game. So it is what it is. So that's in my plans too in the future for anybody who would like to join. What else was I going to say? But I guess that's it. I'm going to try this week, if I can, to make, that video about cotton harvest, for those who would like to see it. I'll just make it an extra, make it a floss tube extra. That way, it's not tacked on to the end of this video. Although, I don't think this video is going to be too awfully long, so it'll be okay. But, yeah. So, if you're going to join us in my birthday start along or stitch along, whichever way you want to do it, let me know below. I'd love to know who all's going to do it so I can look out for that. Also, I mentioned the diamond painting before, if you're interested in seeing mine and my daughter's progress on our diamond painting,
not much from me yet either.
Let me know if she's in here in case you couldn't hear. She said not much from me. Let me know, and I can update you on that as we work on those. Do you want to come introduce yourself, or not right now because you're eating a snack?
Sure.
I'm going to let her swallow her snack. Yes, because you got to meet Harrison last time. This is Reagan.
Hello.
My lovely Reagan. We don't look alike at all, do we? Remind me to insert a picture of myself at 12 years old. Hey, that's my Dr. Pepper, you thief.
I know.
Okay, get out of here. Bye.
Bye, YouTube.
This is how I get sick. They steal my Dr. Pepper, and then I get sick because they have some fungus, and I get it.
Rude.
Okay, not a fungus, a virus. But, so, yeah, let me know if you would like to see diamond painting. On the, also for the cotton video, if you have any questions about cotton farming or production, I don't know that I can find the answer, but I'll try. I do have a lot of friends who are cotton farmers, and I also have a friend that works for the cotton board, I guess it's called. You know, like, cotton, the fabric of our lives. Those people, it works for them. Please pardon that. So I could maybe find out some stuff. If you have any questions about any of that, let me know below, and I will try to incorporate that whenever I do make that video. And I know there was something else that I wanted to mention that's going on, and now I can't remember. You know, it is what it is. If I happen to remember it, I'll stick it in at the end when I'm editing. So that'll be all for me for this week. And we'll see you next week, I guess. Hopefully everything works out and I record again for next week. But we will talk to you next time. Enjoy your stitching this week and we'll see you then. Bye.